Yeah, good morning. My name's Dan Drost. I'm the Extension Vegetable Specialist at Utah State University. Today we're in Syracuse, Utah, where we're looking at an onion field. And today I'd like to talk to you a little bit about soil sampling for nutrient needs in onions. A couple things that one needs to consider when you're soil sampling. First of all, you need yourself a clean bucket to put the soil samples in. Secondly, you need some type of device to extract the soil samples. We are using a soil probe today, but you can use a shovel and take a small segment out of the middle of that shovel. What you would do through the field is you would actually collect samples that are in a W pattern or a Z pattern as you move through the field. So if you think about the way a W looks, we would start in one segment of the field, we would move across, come back toward the middle of the field, move back out toward the far corner, and then come to the opposite edge. Or in a Z pattern, you'd do the exact same thing. And out of that sampling, what we're trying to do is collect a representative look or a representative number of samples in order to get an estimate of what the fertility level in the soil is like. We would take our coring sample, probe that through the middle of the onion bed, push it down to try and take the top 12 inches of soil, and we would extract that out of our sample, placing it in the plastic bucket, and as we move through the field, use that to estimate or use that sample to give us a good representation across the field. The other thing that we're going to need in our field sample is some plastic bags. The plastic bags will allow us, at the end of it, we can take all of our samples, blend them up, and we will need about 2 cups of that soil to be able to send to a soil testing lab. You can use many different labs. They're all over the western United States. They require about 2 cups of soil, and then you would provide detailed information about your field site, which would help them then give you recommendations based on that soil sample for the nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, and trace minerals as you're trying to figure out your nutrient needs for the farm. Once you get your soil results back, you can talk to either myself or one of our county extension staff, and they can help you make an interpretation as to what that sample means.